Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome to my Monday Night Raw review tonight. Once again, another 3-hour Raw tonight. We are days away from SummerSlam. Real big show coming up, so let's start off kicking off the show with the WWE Champion CM Punk going against the Big Show. I don't know if CM Punk's really healed, you ask me. The crowd looked like they were really on with him tonight in Dallas, Texas, especially when he came out. It was clobbering time, people. I like to say that. The match was going out well, I would say. So Daniel Bryan came out, and the crowd just pretty much exploded, saying, yes, he should get a title shot. He's like, why is Daniel Bryan out? Maybe we should put him in the title shot. Make it a fatal four-way. Why is he going against Kane anyway? We'll put all five of them in. We could just had a championship scramble this Sunday. Big Show, Punk, Cena, Daniel Bryan, and Kane. But it was pretty much going. Daniel Bryan kept saying he wanted a title shot to the announcers, and he pretty much jumped in the ring and put the no lock on or yes lock on CM Punk, and Big Show attacked him then, and Cena pretty much came out. But AJ would come out then and just tell them that tonight would be a tag team match. Daniel Bryan and the Big Show versus CM Punk and John Cena, which he didn't really want to even be his tag team partner tonight. Other stuff that happened on the show tonight. JTG, who still surprisingly has a job there. I don't know what he said over Twitter this weekend, but he said he needs to be on Raw. He should be getting a shot and all that. And AJ said, go to the ring tonight. And pretty much, he gets Ryback, which gives him a things on that with the Feed Me More. And Ryback is over now, I'll say that. We still get the Goldberg chance, but I don't know. He's like in a, people say he's like in a gray area. You don't know if he's a heel or a face, but he's going to dominate. I'll say that, but if it's like another Goldberg streak, we'll see, because these Feed Me More chants are insane, pretty much destroying JTG out tonight in there. Shawn Michaels is there, pretty much for the contract sign between Brock Lesnar and Triple H. R-Truth went against the one-man hit band, or one-man band, whatever. Heath Slater, True, picked up the win, and pretty much the primetime players came out attacked. They don't have a manager anymore, unfortunately. WWE are idiots to release AW Abraham Washington. I thought he was really doing good as a manager. He was funny, but I guess he got a little bit controversial when he was bashing the social media, and I guess people keep bringing up the whole Kobe, whatever, Colorado thing, hotel room and stuff. I thought he was good. I feel it was stupid that they fired him, though. It's a shame, but what are you going to do? Booker T, since we have a last fight on SmackDown, the match is canceled. It's off. He's not going to do it. It's not going to be a World Heavyweight title match on the ladder. I heard he's got to get a new number one contender. But here's a match I'm surprised actually happened tonight. Sin Cara versus Tenzai. Why did this happen? The wannabe Mysterio versus Albert. Mr. Box himself versus A-Train. And I'm surprised Sin Cara actually beat A-Train's got to go back to Japan. I'm sorry. His run isn't even that good. Sin Cara, I'm surprised he still has a job here. He has many injuries. He gets and botches every move in the ring. Sin Cara is, he's a botch fest. He defines botchamania like Sabu. Because I saw the UMO side. Shout out to the UMO, botchamania. Watch that show. I'll say that. Tonight on Monday Night Raw, the Piper's Pit. I'd say it's a car match, but Piper's Pit. You get the vote with me on there. Jericho, The Miz, or Ziggler. And Piper's just sounds crazy as ever. He just keeps talking out of his mind and everything, and pretty much talking about Jericho, Ziggler, and Miz. He's in a movie. It's about frogs. Y2J. And Jericho looks like, I know your father. I'll say Jericho, Piper is just crazy on Piper. He's like, no! Miz tried to take the mic from him and everything. And pretty much this Sunday also, Miz is going to go against Rey Mysterio for the Intercontinental title. Yeah, and can Jericho set up the big one? He's got to win the big one this Sunday. Can he beat Dolph Ziggler? And pretty much after the Piper's Pit, is a triple threat match. Jericho versus Miz versus Ziggler, which I thought was a really great match. I'll say it was a great match. with those three. I thought it was an awesome match. I said that was one of the best matches of Monday Night Raw tonight. I want to see what Jericho and Ziggler are going to do this Sunday. I'm really looking forward to it. So I'm hoping it's real good this Sunday, because this is going to be a great match, I'll say that, when I'm Jericho and Ziggler. You know, it's not for anything, but it's just going to happen anyway, just to happen. So, yeah, it was just going to go down, pretty much. But, moving on with the show of, sorry about that, I was a little sick, but, it was a good triple threat match. That was the best match tonight, real good. So, Ziggler picked up the win. Caitlyn and Layla went against Beth Phoenix, which I'm surprised is still there, and Eve. Pretty much talking to CM Punk saying, you got this new look now and stuff, and Cena says this, I don't know. And it was kind of funny because people chanted, we won tables, and where is Zack Ryder? What happened to Zack Ryder? Wow, his push didn't last that long. At first, Zack Ryder was over. Now he's just down. He's not even on Raw anymore. I forget he even has his own show on YouTube anymore. It's like, it was a come and go thing. I know he got himself over, but where is he? Even the people chanted, we want Ryder. Like, what do you want to see this Divas match? No offense, but come on, man. These Divas matches got to be better. As for CM Punk and John Cena going against Daniel Bryan and Big Show, it was clobbering time once again. And it was a good match. It was kind of funny how CM Punk was copying Cena's moves with the shoulder block, and the protobomb when he did the You Can't See Me. At least the crowd actually chanted You Can't See Me with CM Punk, and Cena tried to copy his moves with his knee, but that he just ran the damn right. Excuse me, putting both knees up there, doing his bulldog to say it's clobbering time, and there was Big Show sat out during the match, and Punk left, and Cena just pretty much hit the FU, and it was over after Daniel Bryan tried to do a roll up. And pretty much Big Show's gonna attack Cena, but Punk hit him with the title and wanted to shake his hand, but Cena didn't want to do it, and Punk said he's gonna still remain the WWE champion this Sunday at SummerSlam, which I believe too, because John Cena and Big Show are not going to win. I will say that right there. They will not beat. None of those two are not gonna be CM Punk. I know how many times I can march to this, but I'm really looking forward to this. I think CM Punk's title reign is gonna go long. It's been 9 months, people. Look at this title reign CM Punk says. He's almost held the title for a year. Damian Sandow went against Christian. Brodus Clay pretty much interrupted, but Sandow still picked up the win with that neck breaker he does. So Damian Sandow's getting somewhere, I'll say that, but I guess he's in a feud with Brodus Clay now. United States title on the line, Antonio Cesaro versus Santino or Claudio Castagnoli, if you're gonna say. We need a new United States champion. I think it's about time, because I've seen enough of the Santino. I'm surprised he's still the United States champion, people. The contract signers, Brock Lesnar and Triple H. Pretty much Paul Heyman said Shawn Michaels is afraid of Brock Lesnar, and Shawn came out there, and then Triple H pretty much came out there. They signed the contract, and it was just going on, and Lesnar just pretty much got out of there. I don't know if DX is going to try and screw him, because Shawn Michaels looks scared and everything. And anyway, he's about to leave the parking lot, pretty much grab him out of his window and carry him to the ring and just F5 and almost do that Kimura lock on him. And he's gonna break. It's funny how Paul even said, he said, can you take one more step? He will break his arm. I swear to God, he'll break his arm. And then he just, it wouldn't even look broken. I don't know why they even try to put a neck brace on him. And then Paul even just goes, oh my God, he broke his arm. He broke his arm. Oh my God, I can't believe you did it. You broke his arm. You broke it. I think Shawn Michaels will make it there this Sunday. For Triple H and Brock Lesnar, I think it's gonna be an epic match. I'll say that. It's gonna be a full-edged fight and all that, but I don't know what to say about the world title match, and I'm looking forward to the WWE title match also. I really enjoyed this Monday Night Raw tonight. I thought it was a real good show tonight, especially before SummerSlam this Sunday. Let's hope SmackDown can do great also. I thought it was a real good 3-hour Raw what I saw tonight. Piper's Pit, the contract signed, everything. So, you know, comment, subscribe. Notice me, DHOOD, and keep watching Raw. Get ready for SummerSlam this Sunday. Watch my TNA Hardcore Justice review. And check out SmackDown. And keep watching the videos, keep supporting the show, and just ready for Sunday because it's going to be a very big SummerSlam, I'll say that. Let's hope it's great, people. I'm out of here. Peace.